And life cycle. Oh. Oh, we got power chain. Not sure what that is. Boister attack or rune at head of attack Q when target's chain gauge is empty. Recharge one ATB gauge upon slaying a target. Magic increased. Aha, HP increased. Oh man, we got quite a bit though. Alright, we're gonna level up the Neil's. Let's level up her medic. And looks like we're getting not much but stat bonuses. Wow, got quite a bit too. And level up probably you're gonna be wondering why we're on this video while we're still doing this on this video. I'm sure you guys, some of you have skipped the last video to skip this leveling up scene, but we had to do it. And so we're going on to the rest of this area to continue on with Final Fantasy 13. Let's play! Looks like we got a little save point here. We're gonna save, that's for sure. We are not gonna do any shopping. At least not yet. I don't see that it's gonna be important. I don't see its importance yet. We're jam-packed with... Oh, looks like we got something here. Green Ribbon Man. Looks like one of those behemoths from before. Battle Technique Tutorial. Yes, we will view the technique. Techniques are special abilities used by expending technical points, TP. Your party's TP gauge appears below the leader's HP gauge. Yes, I see the golden thing, TP5. Successfully unleashing a full ATB gauge of queued abilities or earning a high battle rating replenishes TP. Unleashing a full ATB gauge of queued abilities or earning a high battle rating. Okay. Try using a technique yourself. Alright? Alpha Behemoth. And now, using Libra. Yeah, R1. Both vulnerable to fire and something damage. Yes. Fire and ice? Or water? Ooh, ouch. Not sure why I used the potion there, because we already have. Well, looks like what's his name is already using fire, so that's good. Guess we'll just pretty much do on attacks. Make sure we keep everybody up healed. Oh, charging power. No real point to switch stances yet. I guess we could, but we'll do it after he releases his power and then heal up. Oh, Nintendo GMR is offline. Yes, yes, yes! Damn, lightning's doing a lot more damage than before. And this Alpha Behemoth seems to be, like, not doing anything. We're just gonna spam some rune here. More damage for back attack? Nope. About the same. Ooh, 700, 700, 700. Looks like the Alpha Behemoth is almost dead. Ooh, extermination mode. I'm not gonna. I was about to switch paradigm shift at the end, but we would have probably still lived. Begrimmed Claw. Alright, we got a data log update. I may or may not, from requests, if you want, I'll maybe upload like a segment where I'm just doing like data log reading, or just like have the data log there so you guys can read it. But otherwise, for the most part, you can look it up if you want to. Libroscope. Not sure what that is. Well, we're gonna assume that's something. And we will find out later, so do not worry about me skipping it now. Unless it's really important, and I'm just making myself look like an ass. Either way, it's good for me. Okay, it looks like we're entering a cutscene here. Oh, what's that?
Sweep team, form ranks!
They must be hunting down Purge survivors.
I hope everyone made it out okay.
So do I. But nowhere is safe for them now. Damn it. Just cause they shared a neighborhood with a foul sea. They get treated like pulse-tainted rats.
People really hate pulse, don't they?
Not hate. More like fear. Tens of millions of people, all scared of pulse boogeymen. They'd be shaking in their beds every night if they knew that Lassie like us were around.
But they purged that entire town.
It's crazy, I know. But the Sanctum Fauci did nothing to stop it. Up until now, Eden's always stepped in.
Different kinds of cults.
Their errors in judgment. Guess humans aren't worth the effort. Figure they'll let us just kill each other off.
Lassie are not human.
Listen, you! That's enough! We're still alive. That's something!
What?
Where is it?
I don't know.
There!
Man, the Starfleet.
They're sealing off the area. They're trying to trap the stragglers. We gotta get moving before we're caught in the net.
Yes, we have to get the hell out of here. We don't want to be caught in the net. And we're not gonna be caught in the net. So we're just gonna continue down on here. Possibly, maybe some bad guys? Maybe some more bad guys? Maybe some bad guy? Some bad guys. Alright. We're gonna fuck you up. It looks like we got a preemptive, maybe. Nope, maybe not. Psycom Tracker 8. Or possibly a B. No, it looks like an 8. Damn. Lightning is pretty powerful compared to the other two. Like, so much more powerful. Then again, if she dies, she's like the main thing. If she dies, you die. So I guess in some ways it does make sense. It makes sense to me. And we're up and up on this area. Lots of very beautiful looking crystals that I would love to just have. Look at that. Looks like ice. Some kind of super ice. Oh, we got some new mobs here. Looks like they're robots that are floating with weird squirmy arms. And we could just continue on with the blitz here. Looks like they're high attack rate characters or units. And now they're backing off. Aha, we will switch to attack. Oh, electroshock, no! What are you doing? Don't do the electroshock. Ooh, Saz. Glad you're okay, man. I am glad you're okay, and I'm glad I didn't have to spam a potion on you. Alright, so I guess for these guys, it's better to just kill one really fast. If they all electroshocked like lightning at once, lightning would probably die. Unless you can do a lot of damage to blitz them away. So, anyways. Next time, we will be continuing on it down this pathway and fighting those bad guys over there. I'm not sure what they are. They might be regular folk, but they look like they're staring right at us. So, stay tuned for more Let's Play Final Fantasy XIII with Turtle. Turtle out. All right.